This video demonstrates how can I pad on a sub area of surface. Here's the chain. First we have here a B-spline surface, and I want now to pad in this area, so I have drawn a sketch in the XY plane, and this is sketch one. Later we will also use a more complex sketch, this one, but now we start here. So okay, in PyFlow we have these elements. First we have here a selector for a face. This object has two properties. Here the source object is the B-plane, and I can select the faces. In this case I use face 1, that means index 0. And this face is now connected to a projection tool here to the face input. I calculate it, and now this knows, and also this other knows which face I want. In this case now I have here a edge select tool. Here is the sketch, the part which I use, and I use H0. I calculate it, and here is now the edge of the sketch 1. And the same we have here on this place. We have here sketch 2. Sketch 2 is mapped, the first edge of sketch 2 is to this edge. So now we go to this projection, and I move it a little bit around, and now I can start, and in this case we see we have here a projection of this curve, and the precision is given by this number, the point count. In this case I have 7 points. Oh, so I can change this number to get a finer model, say 70 points, and we see we get a better approximation. Next thing is I have two possibilities, depends on the orientation. I hide the plane. I can say I want the outside area or inverse the inner side area. So in this case I have the inner area. This is the flag inverse. And now the result is a subsurface of the given face. We see here the curvature. It's non-planar. It belongs to the starting surface. We see it here. So, and now we can, in the next step, start the extrusion. And I start the extrusion. And we see here we have the extrusion in two directions. The red line is on the surface, and I can here change the value, extrusion up and extrusion down. So we get this extrusion on our plane. Here again the plane, and the object is on both sides of the surface visible. And we can do the same now for the other sketch 2. We worked with this one, and we now go to the other. And okay, I here do the same. In the other case I start the execute, and now we see from the other sketch we get the other result. Here's the other sketch. I hide the first one, and I hide the first result. We see we have here the same, and also we can use the inverse. And in this case we get the outer side of our sketch. So in this way I can create some patterns, multiple patterns on a given surface.